Welcome to the Blazor Image Editor tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add and edit profile picture using the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor component. This feature simplifies image handling in Blazor apps, enabling easy editing such as cropping, resizing, adding text, shapes, and filters. It significantly improves user experience in Blazor-based web applications by streamlining image manipulation. First, let me open an existing Blazor WebAssembly app. If you want how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion Blazor component to it, check the video linked in the above YouTube card. I'll start by creating the UI for the profile picture using the Blazor Image Editor component. To initiate this, I'll create a section on the web page dedicated to the image upload functionality. Within this division tag, I'll include an invisible file input element that allows users to select an image file from their device. Although hidden, it will activate upon clicking and will exclusively accept image files due to the accept attribute. Following that, I'll provide a division container with items related to image editing. It will have a class that can change its appearance using CSS styles. The eHide class likely hides this container initially. Inside this element, I'll add an HTML canvas element for drawing graphics or images, configured with a maximum width and height of 200 pixels each. Additionally, an image tag with appropriate attributes will be included. Initially hidden, this image will have its source set to a profile PNG, representing the loaded image's path. Also, see the cross-origin attribute to anonymous. This instructs the browser to load the image without sending any credentials, such as cookies or HTTP authentication. Subsequently, I'll establish an onload event that triggers when the image loads. To do this, I'll create a private async method called onload and bind it to the onload event. Inside this method, I will invoke a JavaScript method to handle the image loading process. For this purpose, I create a JavaScript file named ImageEditor within the www root folder. Within this file, I'll initialize a JavaScript object named CanvasInterop attached to the window object. Within this object, there will be an image source property initially set as an empty string. This property is likely intended to contain the source of an image used or manipulated within its functionalities. Next, I'll define a function called ImageLoaded, which takes an object reference argument. This function is used to draw the loaded image to the canvas element. Inside the method, I'll assign the object reference to the past object reference parameter. I'll check if the image source in the CanvasInterop object is empty. If it is, I'll select elements from the HTML document, including the image canvas and the custom image. Then, I'll create a drawing context for the canvas, set its width and height based on the smaller dimension of the loaded image, and draw the loaded image onto the canvas, fitting it within the determined dimensions. Finally, I'll reveal an element with the eProfile class by removing the eHide class, potentially displaying the edited image or editing tools. Next, I need to host the created image editor JavaScript file. So, I navigate to the index.html file and link the created JavaScript file to access its methods in the index razor. Next, let me move to the index razor. First, I'll inject the IJS runtime namespace to utilize the created JavaScript method. Then I declare the variable named object reference of type.NET object reference. Within the onload method, I'll proceed by invoking it using JS runtime, passing the method name and object reference as parameters. This can facilitate communication between your Blazor components and the underlying JavaScript code. After invoking the JavaScript method, I'll proceed to update the UI to display the editing options for performing image manipulation functionalities. To begin, I'll configure a span element with appropriate attributes to represent the editing icon. This span element will be a visual indicator that allows users to quickly access the editing options. Lastly, I'll implement the necessary styling to customize the images and the editing icon to ensure a visually appealing and user-friendly interface. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the image with edit icon. Next, I'll demonstrate how to implement editing options such as crop, rotate, and image uploading upon clicking the edit icon. To achieve this, I'll set the onClick event within the span tag. This event triggers when the edit button is clicked. So, I create a private async method named edit and bind it to the onClick event. Inside the edit method, I will invoke a JavaScript method to obtain the image source. Navigating to the JavaScript file, I create a function named getImageSource. This method returns the URL of the image, which is then used in edit method of our image editor to load the image. Attempting to select an element with the ID customImage and retrieve its source attribute. Moving back to the index file, I declare a Boolean property named visibility. This property ensures whether the dialog is open or closed. By default, the dialog is closed. Additionally, I declare a string property named dataURL. This dataURL property holds the image sources. Within the edit method, I set the visibility property to true. Then I proceed by invoking it using JS runtime, passing the method name as parameter. Upon clicking the edit icon to modify the image, a Syncfusion Blazor dialog window will open. Therefore, I have already installed the Syncfusion Blazor dialog NuGet package. To do this, I integrate the Syncfusion Blazor dialog component with the necessary attributes. Notice that the visibility is bound to the bind visible property. This property ensures initially the dialog is hidden. If you want to learn how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor dialog component, check out the linked video provided in the description below. Next, I declare the Boolean property named isOpened. This property likely keeps track of whether the dialog is opened or closed. Then, I configure the dialog events tag and set the opened event. This event triggers when a dialog is opened. So, I create the private method named dialogOpened. It takes an open event args parameter. Inside the method, I add a condition: if the isOpen property is false, indicating that the dialog has not been opened yet, I set the isOpen flag to true, indicating that the dialog is now open. Then, I notify the component that its state has changed and needs to be re-rendered. Then I bind this method to the opened event. Additionally, I set the closed event. This event triggers when the dialog is closed. To do this, I create the private method named dialogClosed. Inside the method, the isOpen property is set to false, indicating that the dialog has been closed. Then, I bind this method to the closed event. As I said earlier, when I click the edit button, the Syncfusion Blazor dialog opens. Inside the dialog, I'll show the image editor component. To do this, I define dialog templates. Within the dialog templates, I set the content section. Then I check if isOpened is true. If it is, I configure the Syncfusion Blazor image editor component. Moving on, I declare an image editor instance named image and bind it to the ref attribute within the image editor component. Using this reference, I can access built-in methods like selectAsync, openAsync, and others to add and edit the profile picture. Then, I create a list named toolbar of type image editor toolbar item model, representing various editing tools or functionalities like crop, rotate, text, shapes, etc. I bind it to the toolbar property within the image editor component. Additionally, I define the image editor events and set the file opened event. This event is used to perform actions such as selection, shape insertion while loading the image. To do this, I create the private async method named fileOpened. Inside this method, I call the built-in selectAsync method using the image editor reference. This method call performs an action related to selecting a specific shape or area within the image loaded in the editor, represented by the string argument circle. Then, I bind it to the file opened event. Additionally, I add the created event. This event triggers when the image is created. To do this, I create the private async method named created. Inside the method, I call the built-in openAsync method. It takes a data URL parameter. Then, I bind it to the created event. Next, I will show you how to create the apply button for cropping the image to the required shape. To achieve this, I define the dialog button, set the content as apply, add a CSS class for customizing the button, and set the isPrimary property to true. Additionally, I configure the onClick event. In this event, I will bind the event handler, which is responsible for handling the apply for image to the required shape. To do this, I create the private async method named applyButtonClick. Inside the method, I will call some JavaScript and built-in methods to perform the apply for edited image. Before that, I bind it to the onClick event. Moving on to the JavaScript file, I create the applyImage function. This function is responsible for processing and displaying the edited image within the specified web application context. Inside this function, I retrieves the dataID attribute from an element with the class ImageEditor. Then I use the dataID to get the instance of the ImageEditor component using the built-in getCompInstance method. Then I get the image data after it has been cropped within the ImageEditor. Then I retrieves a canvas element with the ID ImageCanvas and gets the 2D rendering context of the canvas. Then finds an element with the class eProfile. I creates a temporary canvas element as a child of eProfile. Also sets up the temporary canvas size and draws the cropped image data onto it. I clears the main canvas and draws the edited image from the temporary canvas onto it. Checks if there's a non-empty image source property in canvas interop. If it exists, it updates the source of an image element with the ID customIMG to display the edited image. Finally, I return the value true, thereby navigating back to the index file. Inside the applyButtonClick method, I call the built-in cropAsync method using the ImageEditor reference, asynchronously performing a cropping action. Following this, I invoke the JavaScript function named applyImage from the canvas interop object. I set the visibility property to false, indicating that the image editing process is complete, and the isOpen property to false, denoting the closure of the dialog or component. Lastly, I call the built-in stateHasChanged method to ensure UI updates. Look now, when I click the Edit button, you'll notice the image editor inside the Syncfusion dialog component, along with the Apply button. After cropping the image and clicking the Apply button, the image successfully reflects the changes. Next, I will show you how to create the rotate button and its functionality. I create another dialog button, setting the content property to rotate, and the CSS class property to customize the button. Additionally, I set the onClick event. In this event, I will bind the event handler, which is responsible for handling the rotation of image. To achieve this, I create the private async method named rotateButtonClick. Inside this method, I call the built-in rotateAsync method, passing 90 as an argument to indicate a rotation of 90 degrees. Then I bind it to the onClick event. Now, observe, when I click the Edit button, you'll notice the Rotate option appears. Upon clicking it, observe the image rotation. Finally, clicking the Apply button successfully rotates the image. Next, I'll demonstrate how to add a Reset button to the Image Editor component and its functionalities. First, I'll create another dialog button and set its content property to Reset with a CSS class property to customize the button. Additionally, I'll set the onClick event, which triggers when the Reset button is clicked. To achieve this, I'll create a private async method called resetButtonClick. Inside this method, I'll call the built-in resetAsync method and the selectAsync method to reset the image changes and represent the image in its dimensions. Then, I'll bind it to the onClick event. Look now, when I click the Edit button, you'll see the Reset button appear after cropping or rotating the image. Clicking the Reset button successfully resets the image. Next, I will show you how to create Open button for upload image from local. I'll start by defining a new dialog button, setting the content property as open, and customizing the button's appearance with a CSS class. Additionally, I'll configure the onClick event, triggering an action when the Open button is clicked. To do this, I'll create a private async method named OpenButtonClick. Inside this method, I'll call a JavaScript function to handle the local file upload process. Before that, I'll bind this method to the onClick event. Moving to the JavaScript file, I'll create the file select function. It simplifies the process of initiating the file selection dialog, streamlining the user experience when uploading images in the associated web application. This function will retrieve an HTML element with the ID image upload, a commonly used element for file uploads in HTML forms. Triggering a click event on this input file element essentially opens the file selection dialog box, allowing users to choose a file for upload. Upon triggering the click event on the file input element, the function will return true, thereby navigating back to the index file. Within the OpenButtonClick method, I'll invoke the JavaScript file select method using JS runtime. This action initiates the file selection process and prompts users to upload an image from their local storage. Look now, when I click the Edit button and subsequently click the Open button, I select an image from their local storage. Notice that upon selection, the chosen image is successfully uploaded. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I showed you how to add and edit profile picture in Blazor Image Editor component. For more information on the Image Editor's features, be sure to check out the documentation link provided in the video description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.